going on here?
Ah, glad you came. This is Fossey Dugdeep.
Get to know ya. You told me to find Dugdeep and I have. Now what do you want?
The same as you, I imagine. Victory over the Shining Lady, minimizing our forces' losses as we achieve it. Your arrival and impending departure for the caverns beneath Dragonspear give us some new options in that regard. Fossey, tell them about the Barrel of Potion of Explosion.
The Barrel of Potion of Explosion? It's not a Barrel of Potion of Explosion. It was a Barrel of Potion of Explosion. A dozen barrels, actually. The ones you stopped from blowing Boroskir Bridge, Sapphire. Now it's a Barrel of Bush. It's fun and easier to say. What's not to love? The Bush is distilled explosive concentrate. Planted in the right spot under Dragonspear, it could give us a major advantage when we move against the castle. You want me to carry a barrel of potion of explosions under Dragonspear? Barrel of Bush, not potion of explosion. And you needn't worry. In my entire life, I've only messed up once this year. So, take the barrel, keep it safe, hide it where it'll hurt the crusade worse, and when you get back, boosh, alright? Good.
When you're inside the caverns, consult this amulet each time you come to an intersection. It will guide you to the best placement for the barrel. Now, Fossey, would you please excuse us?
It sounds funny, him saying that name. What? Sure, I suppose. I mean, it's my tent and all, but yeah, alright, I'll just go over here, then. Okay, so we got a barrel of boosh and a stone dowser.
The explosives are just one strategy I formulated to undermine our enemy. I've another that you might help with. These flasks contain poison, taken from a priestess of Talona we captured and interrogated. Her evil works can now be turned to the greater good.
Okay.
We know Dragonspear is being supplied via the caverns you'll be visiting shortly, if all goes as planned. If you put a few drops of this in the enemy food supplies and water, we would have an edge when we finally confront the Shining Lady.
Kind of torn on this. Yeah. I mean, I've been taking the high ground so far. Poison an enemy army? You sicken me, Delancey. Is this the honor of the Waterdavian Guard? Given a choice between victory and honor, I know which I'll choose. I can see you'll not be persuaded entirely by reason. Given your reputation, I can't say I'm surprised. Perhaps you're open to compromise. Would it change your mind if I told you the poison wasn't lethal? What if he's lying? Alright, I still don't like it, but I've done a lot of things I don't like in this life. I'll be able to live with this one. Hopefully he's not lying.
Here is the poison. One drop in a barrel of water, three in a crate of potatoes, and all who consume them will soon wish they hadn't.
I would like to analyze this poison before we use it, make sure it's true that it isn't lethal. But I'm not sure who would analyze that.
You are doing the Sword Coast a great service. May fortune smile upon you in your mission. Farewell.
Poison of Terror. Barrel of Bush. Explosive material taken from Kalar's Crusaders at Boroskir Bridge were refined by Fossey Dugdeep. Where before there were multiple barrels of barrels of potions of explosion. Now there is a single so-called barrel of Bush. The destructive capacity of this material is yet to be determined, but it would be wise to be well away from the Bush when it is. Okay. Here's the stone dowser. This amulet in the shape of an elemental's eye is designed to lead its user to a weak point in Toril's surface. And then we got a poison thing too. Did someone else get that? Do I have that? Oh, I have that. Poison of terror. Oh, we can drink it. A single drop of this poison in food or water will render anyone who consumes the tainted matter incredibly sick for some time. Of course, you know I gotta try it. Oh, what'd I do? I got rid of that. What'd I hit? There we go. Where am I? Oh, I'm just running around. Alright, so I'm not dead. I'm in a panic state. Alright. It didn't kill me.
Sword first!
Oh, the messenger. So who do I ask about war?
I have many fine wares.
I have a question for you about this potion bottle. Bottle? Bottle? I'm trying to coordinate supplies for hundreds of troops and you want to ask me about a bottle? Seriously? Oh, it's not this one, not the poison, but the other potion thing that Stefana found. This will take but a moment. Could you tell me anything about this bottle? Finding its owner could have a significant impact on our effort against the crusade. Fine. It's that important. Let me look at this incredibly important bottle. I recognize the shape. Helvdar the Dwarf. He guards the camp's northern barricade. He keeps all his potions in weird bottles like this. Now, if you excuse me, I really must get back to work. Next, I can talk to Helvdar at the northern barricade. Was this... yeah. The Traitor. The unusual bottle apparently belongs to Helvdar the Dwarf. He guards the northern barricade.
An army marches on its stomach.
Can I ask you something? Is this your first major military campaign? You do realize I'm the busiest person in this camp, don't you? I have no time for idle chatter. Warden Two Edge believes I should learn more of those who fight the Shining Lady. I'll not take much of your time, I promise. Fine, fine. Since you're an elf, I suppose I can give you a few seconds. What do you want to know? Quickly. Is this the biggest battle you've ever supplied? By far, the organization it takes to keep this operation running is staggering. I can't imagine how they managed it during the last Dragonspear Wars. What made you join this coalition? I've supplied small flaming fist engagements before, and I'm a proud citizen of Baldur's Gate. When they requested I come along, I agreed readily enough. And you're quite busy? You doubt it? Troops need weapons. They need food, fresh water, clothes, warm boots, blankets, and bedrolls. This expedition wouldn't have made it a mile outside of Baldur's Gate without me. What made you join this effort? Did you volunteer, or were you ordered to come? Oh, same answer. Okay. Thank you for answering my questions, Quartermaster. It's much appreciated. It's nice to talk about something other than how many bedbugs per roll is considered acceptable. If I had time, I'd tell you about the last Dragonspear War. Fiends spewing forth from the castle, Waterdeep City Guard, and Flaming Fist fighting shoulder to shoulder. Then a second time the devils poured out, rampaging all the way to Daggerford. I'm a bit of a history buff. Maybe I'll get to help make some on this venture. Now I have to get back to work. Luck to you. Once I've talked to a few people about their experience in battle, I can return to Warden Two-Edged. Quartermaster Bellegarm is a little too excited to see battle. He's a bit of a historian and fascinated by tactics and glory. He may get more than he bargained for in this battle. Alright, so, yeah, looks like named people we have to talk to. Maybe this person back here didn't seem to have anything to say. Now has something to say. And then we'll try to talk to Thaird. Maiden Cole? Malden Cole?
You want me? Right.
The fair folk rarely have time for small talk.
Oh, not saying anything still.
Troubled times are upon us.
We're both talking.
Aye, let's talk more fight!
Alright. Stop running back and forth, that'd be great. We'll talk to Thaird. If we can get over there.
I need a swig of some strong dwarven ale.
Nothing to say. Vigilant Hassan, maybe? Or Halasan, whatever?
What a bunch of pathetic babies! I've never seen a worse lot in my entire career!
Calm down. Why did you join the march against the crusade?
Battle needs to be fought. I'm a soldier. What more is there to it?
Warden Two had suggested I learn more about my allies. Did you request this assignment, or were you ordered here? I volunteered for the assignment. Can't see what difference it makes. Look, this isn't my first campaign. It isn't my second either, or fifth, or tenth. I may be only a vigilant, but I've seen plenty of battles. Why did you ask to be in this one? Because I love my city. If you've been in so many battles, how is it that you haven't been promoted?
You know what commanders do? They move wooden soldiers around on maps. Vigilance? We talk to the troops. We secure provisions and monitor morale. We keep soldiers alive.
And you are to be commended for it. And even if every fighter the Coalition has survives, the Crusaders will still die. Some of them, most of them maybe, are good people. Hells, some of them are friends. You have a friend in the enemy camp? Tristian was my closest friend till I moved to Waterdeep. We kept in touch. His mother wrote me when we joined the crusade. Asked me to find him, to send him home. I can't, though. My people come first. They have to. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to get back to these drills. Dismissed. You can't dismiss me. I'm not under you. Vigilant Halasan is certainly dedicated to her profession. She's here to fight, but also to make sure her soldiers come out of this alive, at least as many as possible. She has a friend in the enemy camp, a childhood companion named Tristian. It must be a difficult situation to be in, but Halasan is clearly committed to victory. We have more to talk about with her, though.
What a bunch of pathetic babies! I've never seen a worse lot in my entire career!
Is this piece of paper yours?
Let me take a look. Nah, this isn't mine. Looks like it could be a page from the cipher book of Warden Two-Edged. Have you asked her?
I'll do that, thank you. Get it together, troops! Yeah, I know who she is. The encoded page may have come from Warden Two-Edged, who works by the commander's tents. Did I see what's in this box? Crate, or whatever? Oh, gold. Haha. Hester? You talk to Hester?
You are welcome in my sight.
I feel much better, ma'am. Is that one of the sick people? Two-edged.
Did you need something, young one?
I've been talking to people around the camp, as you suggested. I'll be glad to hear it. Tell me, what have you learned of your allies? Everyone has their own reason to be part of this effort, and each reason is valid in its own way.
I'm glad you took my request seriously. Finding out about your allies helps you understand them. It might also help you understand yourself. Here, take this old medal of mine. I had it enchanted at one point. You'll have more use for it than I am certain.
Cool. I've learned much by speaking with others in the Coalition camp. Everyone has their own reason for joining in the struggle against Kalar's crusade. Though they have many different motives for taking up arms against the Shining Lady, all share the same ultimate goal. And we got a medal. Medal of Valor. A Wardadavian medal awarded for bravery in combat. Its silver shine has been dulled over the years. Thaco plus two. Oh, she can use that. She does not even have one. Yeah, let's give it to Viconia. I have her swinging away quite a bit sometimes. Funny giving a Wardadavian Medal of Valor to a drow, though. Ironic, to say the least.
Did you need something, young one?
Can you tell me if this paper belongs to you?
How... where did you get this? Answer me.
Why, what is it?
That is from a code book used to translate military ciphers. You shouldn't be seeing it. Return it at once.
I've helped several of the officers in camp. I even trained Vigilant Halasan's troops. You can trust me.
Very well. I will believe you. Do not make me regret it. I loaned that book to one of Netherlock's lieutenants, a man named Malden Call.
The one over there by himself who doesn't say anything. Call, you say? I believe I'm going to have a word with him. Tread carefully. We live in dangerous times. I should speak next to this soldier, Call. The encoded page belonged to retired Warden Simonetta Two-Edged. She admitted she lent the book to Malden Call, a member of the Flaming Fist.
Did you need something, young one?
Alright. I still need to find Stonehand.
Yes?
Maybe Stonehand went back over here. I don't know. There's stuff, though. Before we do anything else, let's check this so we don't need that stuff. Throwing axes. Special Warhammer. I'm not picking things in the middle of town here. Oh, there's this Pritchard again.
We've been discussing important strategic matters. What do you want?
Never mind then. Alright, let's go talk to Call. Well, Helvdar we need to talk to as well.
Oh! Who goes there? Sorry. A little drink yesterday.
Just your potion bottle.
My bowl. Where did you find it?
That's not important. Where did you leave it?
I lost it playing cards last night. How did you get it?
Who won the bottle?
Can't say. It's bad luck to talk about your losses, and I have another game tonight.
Would 20 pieces of gold help you feel luckier?
I suppose telling can't do any real harm. It was Call who won the bottle.
So Call is the man I'm looking for. Thank you, soldier. You've been most helpful.
Good luck on your mission, but don't take any of my luck.
Alright. Same. All leads to this Call. We talked to Glint about Pritchard yet?
Yes, that should do it. What? Oh!
Nope.
I didn't see you there. Well,
still can't remember.
I did. Obviously I did.
You
I'm talking to you.
Move?
I must have. But it took me a while. Sorry. What were we talking about?
Oh god, shut up, please. We might be fighting you. I don't know. Malden call?
Soon we shall all be together upon Evermeet.
I heard you were at a card game last night. Did you win anything special? This bottle, for instance? So I've been found out, have I? Well, it's too late. I've sent many a precious tidbit of knowledge Kalar's way. The Shining Lady will triumph and leave you all in the dust. You've really drunk the wine she's pouring, haven't you? My death is worth it if it serves the lady. I should inform Netherlock about the traitor. Oh, I thought he was coming to get the... Drop the short sword. I thought we were gonna fight him. Is he leaving? Where'd he go? He disappeared behind his tent. Okay. General Stonehand's over here. Alright. And then we need to talk to, Netherlock as well. Is that Stonehand? Okay.
Well, look who we have here. The hero of Baldur's Gate deigns to walk among us. Aren't you supposed to be spelunking in Kalar's caverns?
I thought I'd report back to you first. I've dealt with that thieves' guild.
That's the way to get things done. Tell me, what did their faces look like when you kicked their rumps all the way through Dead Man's Pass?
I only saw one, their leader. I leaned on her and she agreed to stop the thieving and come to our aid with her guild when battle starts.
Good work. We'll put those jackals to good use in the battle. March them up front, eh? Here's something extra for doing such a good job.
Thanks.
Now, what's the price we agreed on?
Oh.
300 gold, was it?
3,000. It was 500, General, and we also get a potion of mind focusing.
I believe you're right. Here you are, hero. Now, get moving. We've got a war to win.
I've finished dealing with the Thieves' Guild. I informed General Stonehand that the Thieves' Guild will no longer plague the camp. She was grateful for my assistance, and I think she actually believes I'm a good influence in the camp. You know, it's funny, and I haven't heard anyone having a problem with McKinn. Talked to just about everybody. Okay, Netherlock about the traitor. Can't talk to Glint.
Well, look who we have here. The hero of Baldur's Gate. Bloody hells, we've got ourselves another Torsen de Lancey. Well, he's had us twiddling our thumbs for weeks. First, he wants to thoroughly reconnoiter the castle. Then, wait for further troops. Then, the hero of Baldur's Gate has... As you say, I'll leave you to your business then. Watch your back.
Party encampment. Oh, Netherlock's over here. Okay. Alright, so we need to finish up with Netherlock here.
Good to see you.
All I bring news, Marshal. I discovered evidence of a traitor in camp. I found these notes and traced them back to the spy.
We have a spy among us? Do you know who?
Malden Kahl. When I confronted him, he confessed to everything and was arrested. He wasn't arrested. He kind of ran away and hid behind a tent or hid in a tent.
Malden Kahl. I knew him well. I thought I did. We have to tighten our security. No one can be trusted anymore, not even our own forces.
Thank you for bringing this to my attention. I can offer you this short bow as a reward. That's appreciated. Get out of here then. Dismissed. I hope it's a magic short bow. I reported the traitor's name. I told Marshal Netterlock of Malden Call's treachery. He was upset at the thought of a traitor in camp, but was glad I handled it. We have to be more careful going forward. No one can be trusted. Not even ourselves. Alright, so let's see if we can identify some of these things. Okay. Flesh Ripper plus two. Oh boy. Despite this short bow's intimidating name, it carries no gruesome history. Kitsana, an elven ranger, designed this bow for her own use and could fire it with astonishing rapidity. One night at camp, Kitsana's party each took a turn trying to master the unusually thin bowstring and uniquely carved grip of the weapon. None shot as poorly as the fighter, a braggart named Tyrrell, who not only missed his target by a foot, but who snapped the bowstring down the length of his forearm and tore off a strip of skin. Kitsana and her party faded into obscurity decades ago, but her bow still circulates. Minus 5% chance of hasting the wielder for... Okay, not minus. I think that's... Yeah, it's just a dash. 5% chance of hasting the wielder for 4 rounds. Movement speed plus 2. Thaco plus 2. Damage plus 2. Speed factor 4. Okay, apparently Pure Thief can use. Unfortunately, it's going to make her run ahead of the party. But Thaco and damage go up. Okay. And then we got a short sword plus one. That'll go in there, cool. I'm holding on to the other bow for now. Put down there. Yeah, in this. Warhammer plus one. Alright, so we should sell these two weapons.
What?
I said we should sell those two weapons. Can we sell them to what's her name? Wizab? Whatever. Still there? Well, she's still hanging out over there. Well, I think she might still be over there. Let's just go sell it to this guy. Belagorm.
I have many fine wares.
I have a couple fine wares. You can have them. Yeah. Alright, we got these things we need to find from the Crusader camp. I can't ask Lint. I'm gonna try again. Need to find a blackthorn tree. I need to hunt a bear in Dead Man's Pass. And Dragonspear Castle. Go find Skie. Clint Gardnerson.
Yes, that should do it. What?
Oh, okay. I didn't see you there. Well, I did. Obviously I did. I'm talking to you. I must have.
Who's
but
Wilhelmina?
It took me a while. Sorry. What were we talking about?
You! You there! You look moneyed and in dire need of Wilhelmina's miracle turnip juice.
We do need turnip juice for... What's her name? Take the mad woman away. Miracle turnip juice? This is gonna be good. Yes, just one sip of my product and you'll regrow limbs, gain blessings from at least three separate deities, and make contact with the dead. I'll give you a sample. Then you'll see the tremendous power of turnip juice for yourself. I'll take a sample, but I won't drink it. You don't need to. Apply the juice to aching and bruised body parts as a natural remedy. Polish steel, silver, and other precious metals with it. Throw it in the eyes of a hated enemy. But wait, there's more. Gods, make it stop. The gods, you say? Turnip juice can help you there, too. Drinking it more than doubles the chances of divine intervention improving your life. You don't actually believe this, do you? We do need this, so... That actually sounds amazing. Okay. Ha! See? I told you? A customer. I can stay. A little turnip juice never hurt anyone. Let her go through the camp and ply her trade. We just need a sample, thank you very much. As you will, my lady, Sergeant Wilch says. Alright, so we got Wilhelmina's Miracle Turnip Juice.
One turnip juice! Don't forget to tell your friends!
Mm-hmm. Now, where's the person who's... side? Sergeant Wilch. Oh.
We're few, but fierce.
Who goes there? Wait, I know you. How about this, boys? The hero of Baldur's Bloody Gate graces us with her presence. I am just a woman, no more, no less than you or any other person in this camp. Aye, right. No more, no less, yet you go where you will, when you will, and I'm stuck here, thirsty and eyes dry from watching for crusaders. I heard a girl pass this way not too long ago. Dark hair, pouty lips, probably pouty everything else. I don't suppose you've seen her. The one complaining about her blisters? Aye, she was here. Headed that way, towards Dragonspear. Yeah, my thanks, friend. Luck to you. We already knew that. So let's go to... over here. I think would be... The intricately designed crest of Waterdeep adorns this banner, which is kept in pristine condition by wards woven into its fabric. Oh, where's Nira? Yep. Oh, wait. I want to look at this. Wilhelmina's Miracle Turnip Juice. According to its creator, this miracle juice will regenerate lost limbs, cause deities to bless the drinker, and can even help the user speak with the dead. You're fairly sure it's just juice turnip, however. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. But it'll help Nira, so it's a good thing.
Hey! Found anything else on my list yet? Getting pretty sick of Adoy running around in my head.
Turnip juice. Take it. I don't want it. I'm actually pretty surprised you found any. Turnips are very nutritious. I know. Can I have it? Absolutely. Here you go. Thanks, Sapphire. I really appreciate this. You have no idea.
Anything else on the list?
That's all I got. Alright, we need one more thing. I gave Nira some turnip juice, one of the ingredients she requires for the potion to rid herself of Adoy's constant presence. Whoever thought that would come in handy? I purchased the juice from a very dedicated gnome.
Huh?
All we need now is the Belladonna. From somewhere. And believe it or not, we're done here in this encampment. It's been quite a long time spent here. Quite a few many things to do. But we're ready to move on. I want to thank you guys for watching. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.